سبحان الملك القدوس.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. من أراد به خيرا فقهه في الدين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له إله الأولين والآخرين. وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبده ورسوله المصطفى الأمين صلى الله عليه وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين وأصحابه والتابعين ومن سار على نهجهم إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، سلام الله عليكم ورحمته وبركاته. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who has granted us the opportunity to witness and fast yet another day of this Mubarak month of the Quran. And in keeping with this description of this Mubarak month, we continue our journey towards gaining a better understanding of the glorious and the noble Quran. We therefore start our segment, respected and beloved listeners, with the first verses of the 11th juz, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exposes the deceitful ways of the hypocrites. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states, يَعْتَذِرُونَ إِلَيْكُمْ إِذَا رَجَعْتُمْ إِلَيْهِمْ. They will come to you. Who are they? The hypocrites. They will come to you after you have returned. They will come to you with various and different excuses. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that when the believers go back to Al-Madina, the hypocrites will begin apologizing to them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then goes further and states, قُلْ لَا تَعْتَذِرُوا لَن نُؤْمِنَ لَكُمْ. Say, present no excuses, for we shall not believe you. Imam Ibn Kathir rahmullah, the giant commentator of the glorious and the noble Quran, under the commentary of this verse, he explains, what does it mean to say, present no excuses, for we shall not believe you? It means we shall not believe whatever you say. Why, respected and beloved listeners? It is well known and well documented upon the tongue of the Nabi of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that when it comes to the traits and the attributes of hypocrites, so Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu narrates, Anna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qal, Ayatul Munafiq thalath, that the signs of the hypocrite are three. إِذَا حَدَّثَ كَذَبَ وَإِذَا وَعَدَ أَخْلَفَ وَإِذَا أَتُ مِنَ خَانَ. When he speaks, he tells lies. When he makes promises, he breaks those promises. When he is entrusted with something, he becomes dishonest and deceiving. This was reported by Imam Bukhari rahimahullah ta'ala as well as by Imam Muslim rahimahullah ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then goes on further and states, قَدْ نَبَّأَنَا اللَّهُ مِنْ أَخْبَارِكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already informed us of the news concerning you, O hypocrites. Meaning, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has exposed your news to us. وَسَيَرَى اللَّهُ عَمَلَكُمْ وَرَسُولُهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger will observe your deeds. What does this mean? Your actions will be made public to the people in this life. The hypocrites, your actions will be made public. Sooner or later, you will be exposed. Your actions will be made public to the people in this life. ثُمَّ تُرَدُّونَ إِلَىٰ عَالِمِ الْغَيْبِ وَالشَّهَادَةِ. And in the end, you will be brought back to the All-Knower. That is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who is all-knowing regarding the unseen and the seen. Then He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, will inform you of what you used to do. What does this mean? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will inform you, O hypocrites, of your deeds, whether they were good or evil, and will recompense you for them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then tells us that the hypocrites will go out of their way to apologize to the believers, so that the believers turn away from them without admonishing them. They fear admonishing from the believers. Therefore, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered disgracing them by turning away from them. For they are what? Rijasun. Meaning they are impure inwardly and in their creed, in their belief. Their destination in the end will be Jahannam. In another place, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states, Innal munafiqina fid darkil asfali minan nar. Indeed, the munafiqeen and the hypocrites are in the lowest level of the fire of Jahannam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then goes on further and then he states, جَزَاءً بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ, a recompense for that which they used to earn. Meaning of sins and evil deeds. Allah said that if the believers forgive the hypocrites when they swear to them, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَرْضَى عَنِ الْقَوْمِ الْفَاسِقِينَ, certainly Allah is not pleased with the people who are fasiqeen. Meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not pleased with those who rebel against the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and those who rebel against the obedience of his Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. So that concludes Surah At-Tawbah. It ends where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we mentioned in the beginning, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exposes the deceitful ways of the hypocrites. The Jews then continues on to Surah Yunus. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this surah, one of the central themes of this surah is identifying the awliya of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that his awliya, his close friends and allies, are those who believe and have taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala defined them, every pious, God-fearing person is a friend of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, Allah says, La khawfun alayhim. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the friends of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he describes his close friends and allies, he starts off by describing them as La khawfun alayhim. No fear shall come upon them. Imam Ibn Kathir rahmahullah states, it means that no fear shall come upon them from the future horrors they will face in the year after. وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ, nor shall they grieve over anything left behind in this world. Subhanallah. The close friends of Allah, the awliyaullah, they are the ones, no fear shall come upon them from the future horrors they will face in the year after. Nor shall they grieve over anything left behind in this world. The giant commentator of the glorious and the noble Quran, Imam Muhammad ibn Jarir al-Tabari, rahimahullah ta'ala, he recorded that Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu said that Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam states, إِنَّ مِنْ عِبَادِ اللَّهِ عِبَادًا يَغْبِطُهُمُ الْأَنْبِيَاءُ وَالشُّهَدَاءُ, among the servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there will be those whom the prophets and the martyrs will consider fortunate. Subhanallah. Among the servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there will be those whom the prophets and the martyrs will consider fortunate. It was said, who are these people, Ya Rasulullah, O Messenger of Allah, so we may love them. The Nabi of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam responded, هُمْ قَوْمٌ تَحَابُوا فِي اللَّهِ مِنْ غَيْرِ أَمْوَالٍ وَلَا أَنْسَابٍ وُجُوهُمْ نُورٌ عَلَى مَنَابِرَ مِنْ نُورٍ لَا يَخَافُونَ إِذَا خَافَ النَّاسِ وَلَا يَحْزَنُونَ إِذَا حَزِنَ النَّاسِ. These are people who loved one another only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, without any other interest like money or kinship. They loved one another only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, without any interest like money or kinship. For these people, their faces will be light upon platforms of light. They shall have no fear on that day. Which day? The day of Qiyamah. When fear shall come upon the people, we know the tremor of the day of Qiyamah. We know the trials and the tribulations of Qiyamah. On that day, the awliyaullah, those people that loved one another only for Allah's sake, that did everything only for Allah's sake, they shall have no fear on that day, nor shall they grieve when others will be seen grieving. Then the Nabi of Allah recited, Ala inna awliya Allah la khawfun alayhim wa la hum yahzanun. Behold, verily, the awliya, the friends and the allies of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no fear shall come upon them, nor shall they grieve. So this in a nutshell is what the central or one of the most central themes of Surah Yunus is all about, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes his close friends, describes his allies. So here, respected and beloved listeners, Surah Yunus concludes, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala introduces us to Surah Hud, the Nabi of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam mentions about Surah Hud, where he states, شَيَّبَتْنِي سُورَةُ هُود وَأَخَوَاتُهَا. Surah Hud and its sisters made me grey. This was because of the different punishments which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala handed out to various nations because they rejected His oneness and because they rejected the Anbiya and the Prophets which He sent to them. So this concludes the 11th juz. So what lessons do we learn from this juz, respected and beloved listeners? First and foremost, we learn that the Quran is the ultimate book of wisdom. The Quran is the ultimate book of wisdom. The Quran is also a mercy, blessing, and a cure for the problems of not only Muslims, but humanity at large. The Quran is a mercy, blessing, and a cure for the problems of not only Muslims, but humanity at large. This juz also reminds man that man is at a complete loss when he is ungrateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Man is at a complete loss when he is ungrateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also constantly reminds his creation of his mercy. In this juz, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala constantly reminds his creation of his mercy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also tells us that whatever good you do or whatever bad you do, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a witness thereof. Whatever you do of good or bad, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a witness thereof. Last but not least, if Allah afflicts you with any loss or wants to bestow any profit on you, none can avert it. In other words, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to benefit you with anything, there is nobody, there is nothing that can take it away from you. So this concludes our segment. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us all the understanding of what has been mentioned. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the ability to put into practice what has been mentioned. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen.